An offshore fishing trip doesn't begin with a cloud of diesel smoke and a wild charge into the rising sun. It begins the day before with meticulous preparation. Preparation that's relished rather than resented, because it's part of the zen of fishing. A 52 Viking like the Bella Maria needs to be fueled, because she drinks a lot of it. The engine oil and coolant has to be checked. The crew needs nutritious food to keep their strength up and something to wash it down with. And it's always a good idea to provide a snack for the fish too, so natural bait has to be cleaned and brined overnight. The lures have to be inspected for any nicks in the leader and dull hooks. And come morning, after the fish boxes on the boat have been iced, the rods and reels have to be deployed into the cockpit just so. But the time to cast off the lines and slip through the sleeping harbor and into the Gulf does come. And that's when you put the pedal to the metal. Our plan was to run to the Nipple south of Pensacola, where we hoped the annual late summer white marlin bite would be underway. As it turns out, it was a plan and a hope shared by every captain and crew from Orange Beach to Destin. The place was a parking lot. There were big boats, little boats, boats with towers, boats without. Flying bridge boats and express boats. But the question was, were there any fish? To answer that question, we spread our wares upon the waves. On the Bella Maria, that means 7 lines with hooks, 3 natural baits long, 4 lures short, and a teaser on each side. Putting out that spread and checking those lines constantly to clear grass off the hooks or change out the natural baits is tedious, hot work when nothing is happening.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain. Gang, can't you hear them saying, I'm going home one of these days. I'm going home, see my woman, whom I love so dear. But meanwhile, I've got to work right here. That's the sound of the men working on the chain. Gang. That's the sound of the men working on the chain. Gang. All day long they're saying,
And if you're not working, you're watching and waiting and waiting and watching. And eventually, hour after monotonous hour takes its toll on all but the most hardy. Finally, after 8 solid hours without a single bite, we threw in the towel and headed for the house, disappointed but undaunted. A man named John Buchan said that the charm of fishing is that it's the pursuit of what's elusive but attainable, a perpetual series of occasions for hope. This is exactly so, and the reason why we'll fish again.